Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In today's video we'll read from a binary file and write in another binary file according to some condition. Here the source file is sports.dat and the target file is athletics.dat. First we have to read from sports.dat and write only those records where event name is equal to athletics. In order to work with the pickle module, we have to import pickle. For that we have to write import pickle. To write the event and participant in sports.dat file, we have to write a function. To open sports.dat file, we have to write fin is equal to open sports.dat comma wb is used to write in a binary file. First we will initialize a list. To start getting data from the user, we are using while true. While true loop runs without any condition until the break statement executes inside the loop. To get data from the user, we have to write event is equal to input event and participant is equal to input participant. First we will prepare a item for the list. Data is equal to event comma participant. Within square bracket we'll create an item for the list. To write both the data in the list, we have to write list1 dot append data. It will write both event and participant as an item in the list. Here we want to continue the loop until the user press n. For that first we will ask from the user one character, ch is equal to input, want to add more data, yes or no. If the user will press yes, the loop will continue, else the loop will stop. If ch double is equal to n or ch double is equal to capital N, then we will come out of the loop. For that we have to write break. Now all datas are there in the list. We have to write in the binary file. We use dump method. When objects have to be stored in a file, to write in sports.dat we have to write pickle.dump. Here we want to write in the file, then we are using list1 comma fin. Now we can close the file. In this program we are writing code to insert data in sports.dat file, want to read from sports.dat file, and we want to copy the data from sports.dat file where event is equal to athletics in athletics.dat file. And once again we will read from athletics.dat file. But in examination, only copy from sports.dat file to athletics.dat file will be asked. Now we are entering the data's event and participants. We will accept the data from user until he will press N. The first data is Aman and athletics, second is hockey, then horse, third one is athletics, because fourth one is cricket and J. Now we'll stop the execution. We can see the same file in notepad, but it will not be human readable. To read sports.dat file, we should write a function def read. To open the file sports.dat, we have to write fout is equal to open sports.dat comma rb. To read from a binary file, we should write rb mode. Here we will use try except block, and inside try except block we will read from sports.dat file. Try except block will handle runtime exceptions like file does not exist and UF error. Rec is equal to pickle.load f out. Now all data will be in rec. For I in rec, we want to print in the screen. For that we are using printi function. Except UF error, we will close the file. Now we are ready to read from binary file. Write function is writing data in sports.dat file. Read function is reading from sports.dat file. Now we have to call read function. Now we can run the program to see the content of sports.dat file. As you can see, there are four datas. Now we'll define copy sport athletic, in which we will read from sports.dat file and write into athletics.dat file. Fn is equal to open sport.dat file comma rb mode, and fout is equal to open athletic.dat file in wb mode. Fn is the file handle for reading from sports.dat file, and fout is the file handle to write in athletics.dat file. List 2 is an empty list in which we will write data whose event name is athletics. Before reading, we will use try and except block, which is helpful to handle runtime exceptions. Between try and except block, we can write the code that can generate an exception, and in except block below except keyword, we'll write what to do when an exception occurs. To get data from sports.dat file, we are writing rec is equal to pickle.load fn. Now we loop through the record for I in rec. If I0 is equal to athletics, then we will write in fout, which is athletics.dat file. List2.append, within bracket we will write I. It will append only those records whose event name is equal to athletics. Now pickle.dom we will write inside fout, For that we have to write list 2 comma f out. It will write all those data whose event name is equal to athletics in athletics.dat file. In except part, we will close both the files. fin.close and fout.close will do this job. To read from athletics.dat file, we have to write another function. Now we have to call the function copy sports athletics. To read from athletics.dat file, we have to use the same code of reading sports.dat, and we can do the necessary changes. Here we want to read from athletics.dat file. For that we have to write fout is equal to open athletics.dat comma rb mode. First we'll call a read function, then we'll call copy sport athletic, at last we'll call read athletic. Let us check from the beginning. Here we left open fin.open and also fout.open and list2.append we have to write in round brackets. To get a message before reading, we are writing print sports.dat file contains. Before reading the athletics.dat file, we are writing print athletics.dat contains. We are having three functions, one to read sports.athletic file, which is read. To copy from sports to athletics, we are having copy sports athletic. To read from athletic, we are having read athletics code. Now we can execute the code and can see sports.dat file and athletics.dat file. Hope this video is beneficial to you. Thanks for watching.